वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट द ट्रांसफॉर्म प्रॉपर्टीज इन आफ्टर इफेक्ट इन माय नेक्स्ट ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज. सो लेट्स ओपन द आफ्टर इफेक्ट. इन आफ्टर इफेक्ट आई एम टेकिंग ए न्यू कंपोजिशन एंड taking a new solid layer. So you can choose the any kind of color. So first of all, before starting the animation or knowing the transform properties, we have to know about the keyframes. So keyframe is basically a point which shows the change of value with the time. So in After Effects there is a five kind of transform properties. If you open this arrow, you can see these transform properties: anchor point, position, scale, rotation and opacity. So basically these five pandavas is transform properties, and you can animate every transform properties and make the kind of motion effects which are used in motion graphics. So first of all, I start with the scale properties. So it is always good to use the shortcut keys or the hot keys. So S is the shortcut keys for the scale. Just press the S, you can see the only scale properties open. If you see in this scale property, there is a two value, 100 and 100. So the first 100 value is representing the x axis value, and the second 100 value is representing the y axis value. You can also see the kind of a stopwatch, and when you click the stopwatch, this means you started the animation, and you can see a kind of diamond shape point. This is called keyframe. So suppose I want to make an animation in which we need this solid layer with the 100% scale at 0 in a start, and after 1 second I want it to disappears from the screen, so we have to give the value of the 0. So in animation, after pressing the stopwatch, we have to just change the value time to time. We have no need to click again on the stopwatch, because if you click again on a stopwatch, it will remove the all animation from the layer. So now we can see, after pressing the space bar, you can play the animation, and this is the scale animation. So you want to repeat the same animation in timeline again, so just select these two keyframes and control C for the copy, again control V for the paste. Again you can repeat the same, control C and control V, control C and control V. So this is the repetitive animation of this. So in this scale property, you can see there is a animation of the uniform scaling of the layer. But if I want a scaling in particular axis, the animation of a scaling in particular axis, then you have to click this lock. You have to unlock first, and then you can easily manage the particular axis animation. So suppose I started with the animation that y axis, the value of y axis will be 0, and after the 1 second the value of y axis will be the 100. So now you can see the animation, and this kind of animation you can achieve. So suppose kind of shutter opening speed, shutter opening kind of effect I have to make, then you have to just select the anchor point, because the anchor point is in middle, so the scaling will be from the center. So you have to just move the anchor point from this to this point. So how to move anchor point? We have to use the pan behind tool and just drag this anchor point to this point. And now you can see the same animation now changed, and it's kind of shutter animation. So if you oppose, just give the opposite value, you can see the . So I am going to click the last keyframe, copy paste, and the first keyframe, copy paste. So now you can see the value, just drop down the shutter and just. So these kind of effects can be made with the scale effect. So another effect is I am talking about another transform property is the rotation. So suppose I am taking a solid layer again and just resizing it. You can also resize the layer on the screen itself. So there is a facility given in the After Effects that you can resize the layer on the screen, composition screen. So that will not be a problem for us. So just I resize the layer, and now I have to give the animation of the rotation. So how to do the rotation animation? So if you press the shortcut R, that is the rotation property. So this is just degrees of rotation for the angles. You can see the degree of rotation, and if you complete the 360 degree, then you can see that there is a one complete rotation. So this is the number of cycle of the rotation, how many complete cycles of the rotation. So that is the two value here. So I just starting the my animation with the initial state, it will be the 0 0, and after the 10 seconds it will complete the 50 cycle of the complete rotation. So this will rotate like this. But if we see that in real life there is no this kind of the rotation is I have seen. So how it will match with the real life? So there is a one element is missing, and that element is called motion blur. So how to put motion blur in a layer? For giving a motion blur, we have to first of all on this icon, because it will enable the motion blur to the whole composition. And in a composition there is a many layers, so you have to choose on which layer you have to on the motion blur. So if I want to apply the motion blur on this layer, then you have to click the motion blur here. So now you can see the animation is taking the motion blur now, and that is looking like some real kind of animations. So this is the basic use of the rotations. You can use the rotation, and that's it. Now I'm talking with the third properties, transform properties, and that is position. So suppose I want to move any object from one position to another position, then we need to take the property and animate that property, that is the position. So suppose this box is moving from here to here. So how to move? So for the moving, we have to just press the P. This is the shortcut for the position property, and just click that, and after 2 seconds I want to that movement in this layer, and that layer should be from here to there. So now you can see the animation from one place to another place. If you click this layer, you can also see the animation path, and you can modify the animation path, the kind of moving this path. So kind of adding the keyframes between, and you can change the path in runtime. So that is basically a position property, and you can see the two value, and that is again the value, the movement of x axis, the movement in y axis. It's same as the scale, as you've seen that the scale in x axis and scale in y axis. So you can also move the layer in x axis and y axis or free movement. So this is the position property, and you can move anything. The fourth one is the opacity. Opacity is related to visibility of any layer, and if you want to animate the visibility of the layer, then you have to animate the opacity property. For that, the shortcut key is T. If you select the T, then you can see the opacity value is appeared, and just clicking the stopwatch, we enable the animation. In starting, I want to the complete visibility of the layer, and after 1 second, I want to the zero visibility. So you have give the value of the zero visibility. Then you can see this kind of animation happens. So this is the basically opacity. Again, you want to repeat this animation, so you have to just copy the first keyframe and paste it. So again, it will give the value of from 100 to 0 and 0 to 100. The last one is the anchor point. So anchor point is basically a kind of center of gravity center. So if you moving the anchor point, you have to press the A, and you can change the anchor point of layer. So that is deciding the where layer's complete center of mass will be reside. You can also manually move the anchor point by the holding of this pen behind, and you can select. And what is the difference to moving the anchor point? So just I am showing you. If I give the animation of the rotation, so when anchor point is in center, then see the how the rotation is work. So the rotation is from the center, but if anchor point is moved from here to there by the pan behind tool, so rotation will be work according to the anchor point. So this is the difference of the anchor point, changing the anchor point, and you can make the various kind of animation using this transform properties. Now I am talking about the some realistic animations and the behavior of the composition. So how it works? So suppose I have made the again the fan rotation. So I have taken the solid layer. And press the R and given the 50 cycles. So we can see that this kind of rotation, I enable the motion blur. So suppose I want to 10 the same kind of animation, I want 10 copies. And I need to change individual layers, then that is difficult for me to handling the all 10 layers and 20 layers. In that case, we do one thing, we make pre-compose or nested composition. So nested composition is basically composition within composition. So suppose if I take new composition, and I bring back the composition 1 into it. So this means the composition 1 will work as a layer. There is no effect, rotation, transform properties, animation will be showing. That is in composition 1. So what happened here? The composition within composition. Now you can copy the multiple copy of the same layer, and you can easily place anywhere where you want. So Control D is the shortcut key for the duplicate. Okay. Now you can also change the color of individual layers. By using the hue saturation, just go in effect and change the layer color. So now we can see that the same, but if we change in the parent composition, that is composition 1, that will affect in the further next precomposed or nested composition. So that is the benefit of the composition. You can merge the whole composition as a one layer, and you can treat that composition as one layer. So that's it in this tutorial. In next tutorial I'll be talking about the graph editor and the other advanced kind of animation. Till then, bye bye. You can ask any queries on my given mail IDs. Thank you.